Good evening. Welcome to the March 22nd Valley View School Board meeting. We'd ask everybody to rise, and Mr. Bedurs, if you would join, lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. As our attorney forgot, could you quietly turn your phones to mute, please? Thank you. Vice President Felice, would you read the board affirmation statement?
Sure. Our mission statement. Our mission is to empower all learners to be college and career ready and to develop, grow, and achieve as productive citizens.
Dr. Mitchum, the agenda, please.
Yes, Mr. President. I would like to ask that the board approve the agenda as presented.
Motion?
So moved.
Motion seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Ayes have it. Consent agenda. Dr. Mitchum.
Yes, Mr. Quigley, I'd like to ask that the board approve consent agenda items 5-1 through 5-4. 5-1, approval of board meeting minutes for 3-13-17.
Motion?
5-2.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Executive session meeting minutes 3-13-17. 5-3, gifts for Lukansic Middle School, and 5-4, student activity contract approval request for Independence Elementary School with Scholastic Book Fairs.
So moved. Member Bedurs?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Student and staff recognition. Thank you. Liaison reports, any and all from my right.
Just in regards to Wilco, we've had our first contract negotiation. It's going well, and keep the board up to date, hopefully at our next meeting.
We had a finance committee meeting last Monday with Gary and Mike Lopez and Mike Singleton, just kind of going over the second round of beautification projects they have planned for this summer. Let everyone know that we're in excellent hands. So thank you, Gary, and Mike, I think you're out there. Thank you.
We had an academic curriculum meeting to discuss the new science program coming in at the middle school called iQuest, which is a very inquiry-based program. We also discussed the fact that we could have all heterogeneously grouped middle school science next year, and that was the discussion at that meeting.
Okay, I attended the Early Childhood Center committee meeting, and everything is on schedule for the opening of the expanded Early Childhood Center for the fall. Registration is going well, and it's where they expected it to be. I was at the safety committee meeting, the monthly meeting, but then there was also a committee meeting for the safety conference being held in late September, and plans are well underway for that. Almost all the speakers have been secured. We're working with the Bolingbrook Golf Club to finalize details. Invitations and publicity will be going out soon, and we're expecting at least about 350 attendees from all over, including school counselors and administrators, law enforcement, and mental health providers. I went to the Challenge Committee meeting, and invitations were sent out probably about a month ago now, I would guess, for the students going into Challenge in the second grade or third, fourth, and fifth. And they had meetings at Jonas Salk and RC Hill, the two schools that host the program. And I attended the one at Jonas Salk, and there were a lot of people there. A lot of those parents have questions, and they got all their questions answered, I believe. And the acceptance letters were due back March 17th, I think it was. And correct me if I'm wrong, Adam, you were expecting or thinking there could be two classes at every grade level at both schools? Okay. Yep. Yep. Okay. There were parents at this challenge committee meeting as well, and they had a suggestion to that we would could possibly provide a summer bridge type packet to help the kids who are skipping a grade level in math primarily, that they could work on over the summer so they're better prepared when they go into the challenge program. Another point of discussion that we talked about at the meeting was that the teachers need to have more training to recognize the behavior of the truly gifted child, so to be able to differentiate between the behavior that may be perceived as bad versus normal behavior for a gifted child. There was a mental health advisory committee meeting where there were many, Debbie and I attended that. There were many outside resources for mental health screening, prevention, and assistance companies at the meeting, and they had some input as to how we could help them out. There's a state mandate that all schools have to have a program for 7th and 9th graders to increase awareness of the signs of suicide, and so I'm sure we're working on that. A suggestion was also made at that meeting that school newsletters, I know elementary schools primarily, have an article each month on the awareness of mental and behavioral health. And that was it.
Thank you. Anyone else? No other reports. High school board liaison reports. Bolingbrook High School, come on up.
Good evening, members of the board, Dr. Mitchum, as well as everybody in attendance. My name is Kazim Niaz, and I would like to first start off by saying thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak on behalf of the Bolingbrook High School student body. Like I have mentioned in our previous meetings, our school is off to a great start so far, and we have been continuing this trend. Administrators at our school are working extremely hard to establish a proper code of conduct amongst the students. In addition to this, our school now offers advanced placement courses for all students, including freshmen, so they can be enrolled in a higher level class. Our overall school environment has been made much better, and students are also putting in the effort when it comes to taking control of their education. An example of this is that the amount of referrals issued by deans since the start of our school year has been cut by more than half, which in my opinion, that is very impressive, and we will still continue to work to make that number zero. With all school testing coming up in just a few days, students are taking steps to do their best, as this is the first time that our juniors will be taking the newly integrated SAT. As the seasons are starting to change, safety is also a top priority for our students. In order to create a more safe environment for students, I believe it is necessary that safety drills should be conducted more frequently than it is now to help students become more prepared in the event of an emergency. With that in mind, I would like to ask the board if there are any questions regarding my statements this evening.
Anybody got any questions? I'll think one for next one, though.
For sure.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for your time.
Good evening, school board members and the community. I, Sarah Jebbia, am here once again as a representative at Bolingbrook High School. Up to this point in time, our extracurricular activities, such as our clubs and sports, have had record-breaking results. If you didn't know already, our Lady Raiders and guys track and field team are a combined team now. I am one of the lucky individuals to be a part of that team. We have had a handful of track and field athletes that dedicate themselves to this sport. This includes taking time out of their hands to research who their competitors are beforehand, mentally preparing themselves for their meets, and going even further by breaking school records. Tyler Ellimore, a senior on the boys track team, has fully dedicated himself to the team. He shows up for practices, listens to what his coaches instruct him to do, and trusts the system of running. Tyler, 2 weeks ago at conference, broke the 60-meter dash school record with a 6.89 seconds and is also ranked second in the state. Tyler unfortunately couldn't make it tonight because he is on a college visit, but he wanted to thank you all for the recognition of the track team and is looking forward to sharing his experience with you all. He wanted me to say, I think the team is moving along really well. The change in coaching regimens has been a challenge, but that makes our team strive to become better. Our team as a whole is looking positively on outdoor season, and breaking the school record made me realize that all of my hard work and dedication is finally paying off. There have also been PRs, including senior Matt Zolfer, who was seated last out of top 15 throwers at fast times at Lewis University this past weekend. And he wound up finishing third, and he went in with a 38.7, and then he finished with a 45.3. Matt also mentioned that at fast times, most of the guys PR'd individually. Moving on to the Lady Raiders side of things, for the 4x2, senior Claire Young, junior Kayla Perry, sophomore Kayla Walters, and sophomore Kayla Johnson are ranked fourth in the state. Also, Kayla Walters is ranked top three in the state for the 60-meter hurdles. Both the Lady Raiders and guys this past weekend got the opportunity to compete at Iowa Wesleyan University and Lewis University for fast times and top times, and they were both successful. Now let's dribble into some scores. I'd like to congratulate Nana Akenton, who is the All-State Player of the Year for basketball. The team as a whole stayed motivated throughout the season and all supported each other no matter what happened amongst them. They dribbled around anything that was blocking their way, even if that meant blood, sweat, or tears. From my personal experience, I've been in the trainer a lot because I hurt my Achilles tendon, and I see those guys in there all the time, and they're like always like asking them for help, and if they have a problem, they always ask for help. So I think that's like a really big thing that the team like has improved on, is just like all really getting together, and they're really close. So overall, the team placed third in the state against Fremd at Bradley University and all of Red Zone, along with all the fans and the varsity cheerleading team who joined along cheering the team on day in and day out. So sliding over to baseball, their season just started a couple of weeks ago, and they're already at 2-2, and they've so far played four games. I'd also like to recognize the 14 varsity seniors who have committed to a university and are continuing on their academic and athletic careers. As for softball, they have had a lot of returning players that were on the team last year that made it to sectionals. It's been a slow start for them, therefore, they have a positive outlook for the rest of their season. Boys volleyball also just started a few weeks ago and played their first game at Nico Valley. And that was last Tuesday. And also, they had a tournament this past weekend. If you could come out to the boys' varsity volleyball game on Wednesday at 5:30 in the main gym, we'd love for you all to be a part of it. Also, boys' tennis has been conditioning and are swinging over to their first game tomorrow against Plainfield South. Come on out, if you could, at 4:30, located at the tennis courts at home. Also, while you're at it, our girls' soccer team will be competing at Plainfield East tomorrow. We have very talented girls on the team that I see day in and day out practicing like it's their last time they're ever playing soccer. The drive that they have is literally crazy. It's actually at 6:15 tomorrow at our home stadium, so please don't miss it. Now, keep down the racket, because we got a lot coming at you right now. Badminton will all be competing tomorrow at 4:30 at Bradley High School, located in the Bradley North Gym. First time heading to nationals is DECA, who competes April 26th through April 30th. There will be over 18,000 people there, and 16,000 students will be competing in Anaheim, Southern California. I'd like to give them recognition to the DECA to the DECA members who made it. Senior Adam Sosa will be will be competing at Nationals as the fourth place contestant in business services marketing. Sophomore Josh Kirian took fourth place in principles of business management and will be going to Nationals also. The team of sophomore Garup Signe and sophomore Carolina Coretto placed second in sports and entertainment marketing. Bolingbrook High School as a whole is looking forward to the results at Nationals, and I literally have no doubt that DECA will continue to spread amongst the individuals at Bolingbrook High School. I'd also like to mention that Best Buddies attended Special Olympics and won the Spirit Stick, which is a huge honor that everyone strives for. Each and every individual in that club brightens everyone's day, and it's a really good cause. Good job, Best Buddies. Thank you so much.
Romeoville.
Good evening to the board, and thank you guys for having us in attendance today. Six senior girls went to Argonne National Laboratory for Science Careers in Search of Women Day in March. The girls got to meet scientists, they went on tours of labs all over Argonne, and they learned about a wide variety of careers across many STEM fields. It was a great experience for our young ladies. The Exemplary Student Research Program is an opportunity for high school students and their teachers to work with Argonne scientists to prepare a research proposal, design an experiment, set up the experiment, gather and analyze data, make conclusions, and prepare a final poster. Right now, there are 11 schools participating in this program, and we at RHS are lucky to be one of them. A group of students who are involved in this program have been able to go to Argonne National Laboratory two times this semester to use a state-of-the-art scanning tunneling microscope to image individual amino acids for an experiment. Students will be presenting their research at two separate research symposias, one at Argonne and one at Illinois State University. The students have been working with Dr. Nathan Gusinger in the Center of Nanoscale Materials. 18 RHS DECA students received competency awards for their respective events at the state DECA event. Sharaf Abtalab and Tyler Wallace finished fourth in the state for the Business Growth Plan Team event. Best Buddies at RHS is this week. The reason we have this at RHS is to spread awareness and to disable the label. Over 100 Best Buddies members meet throughout the year to encourage one-to-one friendships among the people with disabilities and their peers. Best Buddies is one of our largest and most successful clubs, and we are looking forward to celebrating this week at RHS. We had about 40 RHS students attend a lecture at Lewis, which focused on the history of beginning of Mexican-American border issues in the early 1900s. Dr. Morrow attended this lecture as well, and he stated that it was a very nice event, and it was very nice to see how many students were engaged in this academic opportunity. Our girls' indoor track team competed at state over this weekend. Nia Lee earned second place in the state indoor track for the long jump. I believe she jumped 18 feet 4 inches. And Kanaya Rush earned 10th place at the indoor state in the 200 meter, while Janetta Jones took fifth in the 200 meter. The 4x2 team took sixth place at the indoor state team, consisting of Janetta Jones, Nia Lee, Kiara Carter, Kanaya Rush. The boys track team took third place at the Bolingbrook Invitational held over the weekend. Thank you.
Good evening, board. My name is Brandon Kwan. I'm actually subbing in for our other liaisons. They sadly couldn't make it to this meeting because they were held up at other sporting events. The varsity girls soccer team held their annual Kick It to Cancer game. The girls played BHS and the game ended in a tie. Between both teams, the girls and their coaches raised over $2,200 for St. Baldrick's. The girls varsity team also made it to the semifinals in the Revis tournament, which took place last week. Our girls softball team won their first game under their new head coach, Emily Buckwalter, last week. Our boys baseball team also won their first game over the weekend under their new coach, Mike Scra. At RHS, over the weekend, we hosted the musical Footloose. The cast played to a packed house each night. The show was incredible. Every detail from the set crew, sound, and pit. Lighting was great. The vocal performances and acting were phenomenal. We can't wait to see what our talented students and staff will be performing next year. And they're also performing the Child's Play within the next few weeks as well for the elementary schools. Now, over the last week, RHS hosted a Spirit Week to prepare for the St. Baldrick's Assembly we had on Friday the 17th. The event was successful in raising $16,000 and honoring five families affected with childhood cancer. We had over 25 students and staff shave their head or cut their hair during the assembly. One of our special guests, Rosie, challenged the students to raise over $500 and she would shave her head. We ended up with $2,000 in donations, which we received in about 10 minutes. And I was actually helping out with those raising of money because we were going through the stands, and it was really cool to see everyone get up in their feet, waving around money for us to grab, and it was really cool to see everyone participate with that. That was incredible. We were able to honor Mrs. Julia Wright and her daughter, Lindsay. They have attended every St. Baldrick's Assembly at RHS. Kyle Eichhorst also honored an RHS student who has recently battled a brain tumor. Kyle raised money for St. Baldrick's and for our RHS student and was able to give the family $1,500 to help with medical expenses. The Romeoville Drumline, along with our Sparkles dance team and students from the musical, put on a dazzling show for our kids. Our VIP families also gave us great feedback, and Jonah, a 7-year-old cancer survivor, and one of the kids who we honored, even said it was his best day ever. Brandon, our third VIP honoree, had a great time dancing, and his mom told us that they felt that our students and staff made them feel like family. We would like to thank the school board, RHS administration, staff, and the students for their support for our St. Baldrick's event. We would also like to thank the DuPage Township Trustees for their support at our Baldrick's Dodgeball Night, as well as the members of the Romeoville Police Department who came out to play. We are most proud of our students who made our VIP families feel at home and welcome in our gym. On the day of the assembly, the student body was silent and incredibly respectful when our MCs were reading the stories of our VIP families. We look forward to planning another St. Baldrick's event again in the future. Now, if you also want to look up to the screen, we have a few pictures showing the events. So here we have Kyle Eichhorst honoring our RHS student with a plaque. We have some of the people who were helping out. The top left one is a picture of me and one of our MCs, Tony Franco. Then we have on the right side Miss Julia and her daughter Lindsay. And then at the bottom we have our musical group that sing one of their songs for us. We have some of our shavies. Actually, those are our VIP families. We have Brandon, Jonah, and Rosie. Rosie shaved her head, and you can actually see in that far right photo that she has all the money that we raised within 10 minutes. We also have Rosie again, and then some of the girls cutting their hair on the left. And on the right with Rosie, we have another two of our MCs, which was Emmanuel and Allie. Yeah, my bad. Have the VIP kids again. And then we also have Drumline on the right. And that's it. Thank you for your time.
That's such a great thing. Thank you. Please convey our gratitude for the whole school for what you guys do for St. Baldrick's. It's fantastic that you guys have taken this as your thing and made it what it is. And it'll get bigger and better every year. So thank you very much. You students, we know you got stuff to do. Audience participation. Is there anybody in the audience who wishes to address the board this evening? Seeing none, moving down the agenda. Student due process cases.
Yes, Mr. Quigley, I'd like to ask that the board approve cases A and B as presented.
Motion? Hold. I'm sorry.
As amended.
Motion to accept as
so
amended?
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. For clarification, do we need to change the agenda up here? Or is that just, it was amended in an executive session? Okay, thank you. Where are we at? Ms. Kinder,
Archive 3000 curricular resource for grades 4 and 5.
Yes, sir. Action report 10.1. We are seeking your approval on the adoption of a curricular resource, Achieve 3000, to support literacy development for students in grades 4 and 5. This approval is being sought subject to attorney review of the contract. This is actually an expansion of the use of this curricular resource. We're using it in some pilot situations in classrooms in our elementary buildings, and we're also using it at the middle schools as well. Information was shared at the last board meeting in detail, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you have.
Anyone have any questions? We need a motion to accept.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call, vote please.
Member Boudouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrill?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Next, Mr. Grisafi, Limitless Learning 1+1.
I'm going to defer to Ms. Kinder on this.
Okay. So, Mr. Grisafi and I are bringing this information, or this action report back, 11.1, Limitless Learning 1+1+. This is our year two. Executive Director of Technology, Astrid Welch, with support from Adam Herder and Karen Flores, shared a great deal of information regarding this initiative at the last board meeting. And in collaboration, we are seeking your approval to implement year two of our 1+1++ Limitless Learning proposal. The components of this year's proposal are designed to meet the students' needs of students and staff by providing increased access to devices and increased support for staff. In summary, 8 additional grade levels will now be receiving a 1-to-1 device, joining 7th and 8th graders who have already received and are in use with a Chromebook this year. And we'll also be providing each elementary building with a coach to support staff with curriculum content and technology integration. At the information report, we had 2 videos that shared staff and student voice that we were unable to share. So we were hoping to share them this evening, if you so indulge us for a few moments.
1-to-1 Chromebooks in the classroom, no problem.
Hi, my name is Nicole Stankfield. I'm a 7th grade math teacher at Humphrey Middle School, and today we're collaborating with the 6th graders on what to expect in a 7th grade math classroom with technology. I think the biggest impact on being 1-to-1 is all the different things you can do, all the data that you can collect quickly. I've spent a lot of time creating Google Forms that have been extremely useful in getting data back to me quickly, as well as to the students and being able to provide them feedback. We've done a lot of cool things being able to collaborate with each other in the classroom where the students are able to comment to each other. We've done some collaboration across district with AVM where they've been able to collaborate with different students in different buildings and create different types of problems that other students have to answer and giving feedback to each other, which has been very cool to see in action.
But they've actually done really well. It makes planning easier for teachers. And our lessons go so smoothly. We haven't had any technology issues. I know that's always like been a major concern, but we haven't struggled with that at all. Our students have been able to collaborate with each other, and we've been able to give them feedback a lot faster than we ever would have, like by paper and pencil. So it just makes our feedback to them really great. It's helped us overall.
Digital Learning Day, and what better way to show digital learning than the Kahoot? Except we're doing it with a twist. So Brian here at Brooks is going to explain what we're doing.
Hi, and so what the students are doing now is they are Kahooting on music theory questions, and I put it in Google Hangout so that my class is actually competing against Mrs. Finn's classroom, which is next door, and the students are competing, and as you can see on the screen, well, we'll see in the next question here. The students are answering music theory questions and symbol terminology and stuff like that. This is a Kahoot I created, and the students really love to compete between classrooms. And Jen, go to the next screen. And so now they can see on the screen any of the names with B before it. Those are my students, and the J are Mrs. Finn's students. And as the game progresses, you can see which class is winning and which students are winning in each of both classrooms. And this can be done not only within two different classrooms at the same time, but different campuses. We've actually competed with Humphrey's band, Brooks' band, and BHS all at the same Kahoot. So multiple campuses at the same time doing a music theory quiz. So it's a lot of fun. The kids really love it.
We are wrapping up Digital Learning Day with kindergarten kids who are being introduced for the first time to logging into and using Chromebooks. This is amazing. You're doing great. All right, say goodbye. Say goodbye to the kids. Nice.
So just a few short clips to show some of the amazing things that our educators and our learners are doing with access to technology, and they're really taking learning to new levels. So we appreciate the board's continued support, and we're happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Need a motion to approve.
So moved.
Motion and seconded. Is there any discussion? Anybody have any questions of Ms. Kinder? Are we ahead of schedule on this?
We are. We are going with our intended plan. However, we increased the pace with our high school. And so we're going to be including 11 and 12. So all of our high school learners will have a one-to-one device.
Right. It seemed like it was a little faster when we were.
Yeah.
I'm very proud to say that we, you know, we embarked on this, 3 years ago, Jim? And Astrid and whomever else was involved in that. And we went to California to see exactly what they had to offer. We went and saw Mac, Apple, whatever, and we went to Microsoft and saw what they had to offer. And the decision was made to go with the Microsoft Chromebooks and Google Chrome, whatever. And I'm very proud to say that people in this district and the community supports the fact that we're not only doing it faster than we thought we could do it, but we budgeted for this, and we're now in the 21st century and not going to look back when it comes to technology. So that's the way the world is. You know, I sat up here several years ago, not here, but at the other place, and said books are a thing of the past. And a gentleman came to the next meeting and said, how are we going to have school without books? And I didn't mean that people are still going to write books, but they're going to be on these things. I'm not saying libraries aren't valuable either, because they are, but we're not going to have books going in the future. There still will be people writing them, there'll still be people buying them, but not to the extent that we're going to be spending $500,000 on books every 3 or 4 years in our district, because we're going to put it into technology. We'll still have books, but we're not going to have as many, and we're not going to have the cost, because we're going to have the technology, and it's going to be put elsewhere. I made a very simple comment to my son the other day. He was walking around with his iPhone, and he's asking me some silly question. I said, son, you have the world at your fingertips. It's that simple. You have the world at your fingertips. Everything you want to know, you can find. If you have to do historical research, you can still go to libraries and find things that may not be on computers, may not have been documented or scanned or put in, old and historical documents, what have you. But this is a great place to start. And to give our kindergartners that opportunity coming in the buildings and all the way up is fantastic. I'm very proud. It's one of my proudest moments of this district since I've been on this board. So with with that, for no further comments, I want to thank you guys for the efforts, and Astrid and your crew, wherever you at. You out there somewhere? There you are. And thank you guys for your efforts to this. And I know and I think the parents need to know, the back of the house stuff in this district is very solid. Very solid indeed. So with that said, we have a motion and a second. A roll call vote would be in order because we're spending a lot of money.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Enthusiastically, yes. Next, this is excitement.
Yes.
Little electric main gear, Gary, following that presentation. What do you got?
At the last board meeting, an information report was presented for the retrofit of the main electric gear at Romeoville High School. That gear, which includes the large cables, wiring, circuit breakers, conduits, switches, and panels, is original to the building, dating back to 1963. The scope of work includes retrofitting a 2,000 amp and a 1,600 amp main electrical distribution panel, as well as all associated breakers and wiring for those panels. The contract for this project will be with Wesco Distribution, who is an approved supplier through the Cooperative Purchasing Network / National Intergovernmental Purchasing Alliance, which competitively solicits bids in accordance with public purchasing rules and regulations. All that being said, we do recommend approval of the contract with Wesco Distribution in the amount of $142,374 for all work associated with the retrofit of the main electric gear at Romeoville High School.
Motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
Motion seconded.
No video, Gary?
No video. Got some guys pulling some wire, some big cable, cut it, splicers. We have a motion, we have a second. If there's no further discussion, a roll call vote would be in order.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Enthusiastically, yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Ms. Hawks, Consolidated Action Reports.
Thank you, President Quigley. Action Report 12.1 this evening, Consolidated Action Report for Certified and Classified Personnel. We're seeking your approval on 37 items for certified personnel, 34 for classified personnel, 2 for classified administrative personnel, and 1 for certified administrative personnel.
Motion?
So moved.
Second. Somebody second? I can't hear. Go down, JT. Sorry. You talk to my good ear. We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Next.
Action Report 12.2 this evening, Resolution Number 1573. We're recommending the Board of Ed consider for approval and adoption the resolution authorizing non-reemployment of part-time teachers and teachers hired under a temporary contract.
Motion?
So moved. Second.
Motion seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes.
Action Report 12.3 this evening, Resolution Number 1574. We're recommending that the board approve the authorization of non-reemployment of part-time and temporary educational support personnel.
Motion?
So moved.
Motion, second? We have a second?
Second.
Second. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes.
Action Report 12.4 this evening is Resolution Number 1575, and this is what is commonly referred to as RIFs, or Reduction in Forces. And this evening, we are recommending there are 14 certified positions that are on here, teachers that are being RIFed, and that is due to a decrease in enrollment district-wide, but we saw a large portion of that decrease happening at the elementary level. So tonight I'm requesting that the board approve the authorization of honorable dismissal of certified personnel.
Second.
Motion seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Next.
Action Report 12.5 this evening, Resolution Number 1576. This is the RIF for Educational Support Personnel Employee, and this year it is for
two part-time secretarial positions. So I'm recommending that the board approve the honorable dismissal of educational support personnel for employees.
Motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes.
Action report 12.6 this evening, resolution 1577, recommending that the board approve the non-reemployment of first and second year probationary teachers as listed on this.
Motion?
Nope. Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes.
Action report 12.7 this evening, resolution number 1578. We're recommending that the board consider and approve dismissal of fourth year probationary teachers for reasons other than reduction in force.
Motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. 12.8.
Action report 12.8, resolution 1579. Recommend the board consider for approval and adoption the resolution authorizing dismissal of a certified administrator from employment for reasons other than reduction in force and to suspend said employee without pay pending completion of the dismissal process.
Motion?
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes.
Action report 12.9 this evening, resolution number 1580, recommending that the board consider and approve for adoption the multi-year employment contract for Mr. Derek Kinder as principal of Romeoville High School.
Motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes.
Action report 12.10 this evening. This is a request for the board to waive the first reading and recommend approval of the revised classified job description of coordinator of purchasing. The duties for this position have just been updated to align with the current duties of the position.
Motion?
So moved.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Is there anybody here from the Food Services Group? Oh, just want to tell you thank you for negotiating with Mr. Grisafi and our staff and coming to a quick agreement. Oh, that's next. Oh, I'm sorry.
So action report 12.11 this evening.
I jumped the shop there.
We recommend that the board approve the proposed changes to the policies and procedures regarding nutrition services personnel. These changes will be incorporated into the working agreement dated July 1st, 2017 through June 30th, 2020. The Nutrition Services Department employees ratified these changes in a vote on Tuesday, March 21st, 2017.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion?
This is part of one of those back of the house areas that President Quigley mentioned, but thank you to all the nutrition service people that make sure our kids in the district are taken care of in a timely manner, especially during those high school lunch hours when it's not really an hour and it's controlled chaos, but the students should be recognized, but thanks to the nutrition service people as well.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perrell?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes, information report 13.1 is presenting board policy 7180 for a first reading. This is preventing bullying, intimidation, and harassment. As part of our normal process, we regularly review board policy and update in accordance with school code and legal parameters. And this policy, there's no changes as presented, but we are required to review it on a regular basis. I'd be happy to answer any questions this evening or between now and when we bring it back for approval.
Does anybody have any questions? If not, move down the agenda. Student proposed fees for next year.
Yes, student fees are charged to all of our families whose students attend schools both within and outside the district. The revenue generated by these fees allows the district to provide additional and better quality services than it would otherwise be capable of providing. This year, the administration formed a committee to analyze and discuss student fees in order to prepare a recommendation to the board. The committee discussed the need to assess school fees, the impact on families, and the wide range of services Valley View provides to our students and families, including, but not limited to, all-day kindergarten in our neighborhood schools to all incoming kindergartners, security improvements to all of our buildings, wall-to-wall Wi-Fi, Chromebook distribution and usage protection to all students, expansion of digital content to aid instruction, activity buses for after-school activities, athletic trainers at all athletic events, concussion sports testing, arrival and dismissal supervisory personnel, and preparation, participation in clubs at elementary and middle school. They also reviewed surrounding district student fee schedules and what changes to Valley View student fees should be recommended. The primary changes being recommended are an addition of a tech usage and protection fee. This $10 fee would cover the use and protection for student use of a Chromebook 24/7. This would apply at both the middle and high school. The protection will cover the following events with no deductible: accidental damage, drops, liquid spills, theft, burglary and robbery, fire, flood, third-party vandalism, natural disasters, and power surge due to lightning. The only thing it does not cover is any sort of deliberate acts of vandalism or negligence by the user. Second recommendation is to rename the book fee to instructional resource fee to better represent the resources utilized by our students in both digital and text formats. Fees are generally not recommended for an increase in 2017-2018, with the exception of a band instrument rental fee, which will increase $5 beginning in the school year 2017-18. Beginning in school year 18-19, a recommendation for a $5 increase and another increase of $5 in 19-20 would apply to the following fees: registration fees at all grade levels, a middle school co-curricular competitive and athletic participation fee, the high school co-curricular non-athletic competitive club participation fee, and the high school co-curricular athletic participation fee. Discounts and maximums. The non-discounted registration fee would continue to be applied to those households that fail to register by the last day of back-to-school registration week. Basically, we have an early bird discount. The multi-student family credit, which was implemented a couple years back, would continue to be applied for all families with three or more actively enrolled students. The maximum middle school student would pay for co-curricular participation fees would be $150 next year, $162.50 in 2018-19, and $175 for 19-20, basically providing a 50% discount for that third sport or activity. That same discount would be applied at the high school, with those maximums being applied in respective years 2017-18 of $300, $315 for 2018-19, and $325 in 2019-20. Optional fees for middle and high school band instrument rentals would increase by $5 beginning in school year 2017-18 to defray the cost associated with operating the instrumental band and music programs, such as repair and maintenance of all band equipment. High school student parking would remain at $120. An increase of $5 for the school year 2019-2020 is recommended. Paid bus transportation would remain at $525 annually, and the family maximum of $1,050 annually would continue to apply. High school concert band and choir dress fee of $15 is being recommended to be included in beginning in year 2017-18. And so that represents the optional fees that are being recommended. This is just information at this time. A final recommendation will be brought to you at our next meeting for consideration and action on April 17th.
Thank you, Gary. Anybody have any questions on that? Push the button.
Oh, yeah. I see that for career and tech ed and fine arts for the 2018-19 and 19-20, well, actually all three of the upcoming years, there's a range. How can that, I mean?
Those fees typically haven't been brought to the board in the past. We wanted to include them as being board approved. There are several courses that fall under each of those different headings.
Different courses have different amounts?
Exactly.
Okay. And then the physical education $50 fee, is that for all PE classes? Just the
Adventure Ed and leadership and training, because there's different components to them than our standard courses.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? Moving down the agenda. Legal services report.
No formal report.
Thank you. AFT report. Valley View Council report. No report. Thank you. Valley View Office Personnel Council report. Apparently no report. Any new business come for the board this evening? Any old business to come for the business? Well, I've got that. I put that out of order. Any old business for the board? Any new business before the board? Any questions of the public on actions we have taken this evening? Hearing none, seeing none. Moving down the agenda. Any announcements by the board?
I just have one. I was Saturday night was at Romanville High School for Footloose. Excellent. Very energetic. I don't know how they possibly, I would be on oxygen if I had to do what they had to do. But they were very good.
Had the chance to go down to the BHS basketball games and for the state championship. And one of the things that came out of it was when we were talking to some of the parents and some administrators from other schools and what have you, in particular a reporter, didn't know I was a school board person or whatever. I was just standing there, and he was so impressed with the way that our student athletes conducted themselves, and he said that's not the first time that he's experienced that with Bolingbrook High School students. I hope that he meant Valley View High School students as well, but he said every time we've run across kids from this district, they're courteous, they're polite, they're well behaved. They're a good interview, so on and so forth. And that speaks volumes for our programs. And I will emphasize students over athletes every time, because we have a lot of student athletes, and a lot of those student athletes get very good grades. And these kids put in a lot of time in these athletic programs and other programs we have. It's not just, you know, basketball or baseball or football. Kids in band and every other thing put in a lot of extracurricular hours, and they still maintain very good grades. It's a compliment to the district, it's a compliment to the administrators, the building administrators. We know it starts with you guys and the teachers and what have you, but it's a really good feeling when somebody who you don't even know randomly just starts talking to you about that when you're sitting over in the Bolingbrook section. So congratulations. And congratulations to the basketball team on another great year, and Coach Brost, and I'm sure we'll see those guys in here with the trophy at some point as well.
Just real quick, I sent an email, but I wanted to make a public announcement and recognize the security team at all the schools, but in particular the high schools. Had a chance watching the basketball team play, but and watching our red zone come, but watching the chaperones of our security team, how they handled themselves, they were pretty much invisible. Which is a tribute to them and their training by Mr. Brown and his staff, but making sure that our students get to and from to events is, I think, highly overlooked and never appreciated enough. But so my commendation to the security teams at all the schools, but in particular both high schools, because I know they, being the largest schools, I know they have their hands full, great job, and thanks for making our students safe.
Any other announcements by the board? Any announcements by the administration? Any announcements by the public? Motion to adjourn would be in order.
So moved.
Second. Motion and seconded. All those in favor say aye. Aye. Opposed, same sign. The ayes have it. We stand adjourned. Have a safe evening.